Others, anybody got the answer B and 0? Anybody? Joel, got it, man? B and 0?
No, sir.
Subramaniam?
Yes, sir.
B and how much you got? Is it 0?
Sir, I'm just joined now only. Just a minute, I should solve it.
Okay, okay. Uday Kiran?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'll explain BN and then I will move on to next problem better. So BN formula is 1 by pi integral over 0 to 2 pi f of x sin nx dx, right? So now, since the function is a discontinuous function at the point pi, so just I'll split this interval into two intervals. One is from 0 to pi and another from pi to 2 pi. So now, in the interval pi 0 to pi, the value of the function f of x is x. And in the interval pi to 2 pi, the value of the function f of x is 2 pi minus x. So then it will become 1 by pi times of 0 to pi x sin nx dx and pi to 2 pi, 2 pi minus x sin nx dx. So now you have to apply Bernoulli's rule for both the integrals, first and second. So first apply the Bernoulli's rule for the first integral. So first function is, that is u is nothing but x and v is nothing but sin nx. So that if we know that Bernoulli's rule is u v1 minus u dash v2. So that is u into x and integration of sin nx is what? Minus cos nx by n minus derivative of u. Derivative of u is 1. And derivative of minus cos nx means it will become minus sin nx by n square, where the limits varies from 0 to pi, plus 2 pi minus x into integration of sin nx. So same thing, once again it will become minus cos nx by n. Now derivative of 2 pi minus x. Derivative of 2 pi minus x means derivative of 2 pi is 0 and derivative of minus x means it will become minus 1. Into minus sin nx by n square, where the limits are varies from pi to 2 pi here. So we know that. So now you have to put upper limit minus lower limit. Somebody may get confused with the lower limit minus upper limit. You should not follow that thing. Upper limit and then minus lower limit. So and we know the value of sin pi, it is 0. Sin n pi, 0 in general. Sin 0 is 0. Sin 2 n pi is also 0. So that means, so wherever sin function is there for in both the intervals, so this will become 0. Sin n pi, this will become 0. This term will become 0. No need to apply upper and lower limit. Directly you can write this one as 0. Here also, so since it is 2 pi and pi, this will also become 0. Only for the remaining thing you have to apply the limits. So now, apply the limits bn equals 1 by pi into upper limit. Upper limit means, so here for this term we are going to apply the upper and lower limit. So in this one, which is constant, minus 1 by n is constant, I will take it out into upper limit. Wherever x will be there, you have to replace by pi, that is pi cos n pi minus 0 into cos 0. Cos 0 is 1, x is 0, so that means it will become 0. Pi cos n pi minus 0. So in this term is vanishes already. So no need to apply that one. So now for this term, we have to apply. In this one also, minus 1 by n is constant into. So if you put x equals 2 pi, upper limit, 2 pi minus 2 pi means the upper limit value will become 0 minus lower limit, 2 pi minus pi. That means pi into cos n pi. So now cos n pi value, what is the cos n pi value? So instead of going through cos n pi value, so just to see here, minus 1 by n is common in both the terms. I'll take minus cos 1 by n outside. So here plus pi cos n pi and here minus pi cos n pi. So these two will get cancelled. So therefore bn value will be 0. Understood? Understood?
Yes, sir.
One where you made mistake while applying limit.
The take
Yeah, sir, by applying limits only, especially in the second one, sir, from pi to 2 pi, there I went wrong.
Okay. So, and one more thing, you keep it in your mind. So it will be difficult for this problem because these are lengthy, na? Even if you made single negative sign also, it will affect to the answer. It will take little bit time. Once if you solve some 10 to 15 problems, then you will get flow. That time you will get feel, it's feel, you will feel it's easier. Up to that, you will feel you will made mistakes somewhere, like that only it will happen. That's why at least if you are trying in every class, means after some 3-4 classes, you will come into track. It will take little bit time to adjust because solutions are lengthy. That's why you may made mistake. That's also always where we will made mistakes, means while putting upper and lower limits are signs, that is minus sign and plus sign, there will be made mistake usually. Okay. Remaining thing, will you go through the solution? I have written the solution, full solution. Will you go through the solution? Am I audible, guys? Am I audible? Am I audible, guys, now?
Yes, sir.
It's happening again and again. Shweta, where you made mistake in BN?
So while applying limits.
Limits, okay. So just to go through the solution, just to note down after the class. So next thing, and one more thing, here you have to put x equals pi. This is the, what is that? Point of discontinuity. Actually, I made mistake here. I put x equals 0 and then after getting final answer, I came to know I'm getting the opposite sign. So that's why I thought later I thought after getting negative sign. So then I got the point. So we have to put x equals pi. We should not put x equals 0. If you put x equals 0 means, so that is not the point of discontinuity. One thing, and even if you put x equals 0 also, you'll get opposite sign. So you have to put x equals pi. Okay, wherever point of discontinuity will be there, that point you have to put. So next question, shall I move on to next question?
Yes, sir.
Okay, an alternating current after passing through a rectifier has the form I equals I naught sine x, I naught sine x for 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to pi, and it will be 0 for pi less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2 pi. So this is a periodic function with period 2 pi. So here it will, it's the discontinuous function at the point pi, it will be discontinuous. So that means we have to apply the Fourier series expansion for the discontinuous function. So since the discontinuous function, the number of discontinuous functions, discontinuous points are only one. So that means, so it is finite only, we can apply the Fourier series. So here in this function, I naught is indicating maximum current and the period is 2 pi. So now, so this is nothing but, I is nothing but f of x. We have to express this I as a Fourier series. After expressing this one in terms of Fourier series, just you have to evaluate the value of 1 by 1 into 3 plus 1 by 3 into 5 plus 1 by 5 into 7 plus so on up to infinity. So we have to find out the value of this one. So now, given function I, you write it as some f of x, because we are already fixed for f of x. That's why if you are writing it as f of x means, then it will be fine. F of x equals I, which is equals to, which is defined as I naught sine x for the interval 0 less than or equal to pi. In the interval 0 to pi, it will take the value I naught sine x. And in the interval pi to 2 pi, and in the interval pi to 2 pi, it will take the value 0. So now our aim is to express this current I in terms of Fourier series. After expressing this one in terms of Fourier series, you have to find out the value of 1 by 1 into 3 plus 1 by 3 into 5 plus 1 by 5 into 7. We have to find out the convergence of this series. We have to find out this converges to which point. That thing we have to find out by using the obtained series of this function, I naught sin x and 0 in the interval 0 to pi and pi to 2 pi respectively. So for the sake of simplicity, just I'm taking this I as f of x. Once if you mentioned in the beginning of the problem, beginning while writing the solution, in the beginning step, first step itself, if you mentioned it as f of x means, later we can continue with the f of x itself. Now, we know that the Fourier series expansion of f of x in the interval 0 to 2 pi is given by f of x equals a naught by 2 plus summation n equals to 1 to infinity an cos nx plus n equals 1 to infinity bn sin nx. So call this equation as some star. Now we have to find out a naught, an, bn. Once if you find out the value of a naught, an, bn, and you have to substitute those values in this equation star, then you will get the required Fourier series expansion of the given function I. Somebody told something? Anything? Doubts? In between you don't talk, because if I'm not observing participants means I will not come to know who is speaking. So while I'm asking something means that time I used to watch participants, then I'll come to know who is speaking. Okay. So now find out the A naught relation is 1 by pi into integral over 0 to 2 pi f of x dx. In the interval 0 to 2 pi, a naught, by using Euler's formula, we know that a naught equals 1 by pi into integral over 0 to 2 pi f of x dx. So now, find out the, so because the function is discontinuous, so we have to split this interval. Otherwise, we don't know the exact value of f of x in the interval 0 to 2 pi. For that purpose, you have to split this interval into two parts. So because we know the value of the function in the interval 0 to pi, one thing, and we know the value of the function in the interval pi to 2 pi. So these are there are two values for the function, given function. So for that purpose, just you have to split this one into two parts. That is 0 to pi f of x dx and pi to 2 pi f of x dx. So now you substitute the value because we know the value of f of x in the interval 0 to pi and in the interval pi to 2 pi. In the interval 0 to pi, function f of x is I naught sin x. And in the interval pi to 2 pi, the value of the function f of x is 0. So just to substitute these values, so second integral value, since the integrand is 0, so the whole thing will become 0. No need to worry about anything. So we can write it directly 0 since the integrand is 0. So only thing is now we have to evaluate the first integral. So in the first integral, the limits are 0 to pi, I naught sin x. So I naught is nothing but what? Maximum current. Maximum current means always it will be fixed value. That means it will be fixed constant. So that's why we can take this I naught as outside because it is constant, and we have to integrate the function sin x with respect to x. We know the integration of sin x is minus cos x, where the limits varies from 0 to pi, and the value of the second integral 0, directly I have written it as 0. Now I naught is constant and negative sign also you can take it out. So if you took that one means minus I naught into upper limit is cos pi minus lower limit is cos 0. So which will become minus I naught by pi into cos pi value is minus 1 and cos 0 value is minus 1. So it will become minus 2. Minus into minus will become plus. So it will become 2 I naught by pi. So this is 2 I naught by pi. Anybody is having doubt till now? Anybody? In case if you are not having any step, means you can clarify now only.
No, sir.
Okay. Shweta, yes, understood? Shweta, yes, I'm audible.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Understood. Shreya?
Yes, sir.
Soman, understood, man?
Yes, sir.
Somana, your voice is not audible. Speak little bit loud.
Sir, understood.
What you are telling, I'm not getting only, Somana. Steven, understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Tanushri? So next I will move on to AN. AN is what? Formula first you have to note down the formula. AN is 1 by pi times of 0 to 2 pi, integral over 0 to 2 pi f of x cos nx dx. So the same procedure, since the function is not defined in the interval 0 to 2 pi, it is having the point of discontinuity. You have to split the interval into two parts. One is 0 to pi and one more is pi to 2 pi. So now it will become 1 by pi into integral over 0 to pi f of x cos nx dx and integral over pi to 2 pi f of x cos nx dx. So now in the interval 0 to pi, f of x will take the value I naught sin x. And in the interval pi to 2 pi, f of x will take the value 0. So that means this whole thing will become 0, second integral. So now just we have to integrate the first integral. So in the first integral, I naught is constant, I will take it out. And sin a cos b means, what's the formula, anybody? Sin a cos b?
Sin of a
plus
b plus
sin of a minus b by 2. Sin of a plus b plus sin of a minus b divided by 2. Right.
By 2.
Here, value of a is x. Value of a is, this is nothing but value of a. And sin b. Sin b means it will become nx. This is value of b. We know that sin of a plus b is sin of sin a sin cos b is sin a cos b, which will be equals to 1 by 2 times of sin of a plus b plus sin of a minus b. So just to apply this trigonometric identity, so because we can't integrate that one directly, sin a cos b, so for that purpose just you have to express that one in terms of another function by using the trigonometric identities or trigonometric formulas. So this one, so sin of a plus b, a value is x, that is sin of x plus b, b is nx, plus sin of a minus b, that means x minus nx, 4 divided by 2. Now we can take 1 by 2 is out, constant, we can take it out. So I naught is also constant, we can take it out. So if you took I naught by 2 outside, means it will become I naught by 2 pi into integral over 0 to pi sin of this one. In this one, x is common, so that's why I'll take x outside, that means 1 plus n into x. So you should not take this x in front of sign. So you have to keep as it is like this only, sin of 1 plus n into x plus sin of 1 minus n into x. So these things you have to integrate with respect to x. So now sin, integration of sin ax is what? Integration of sin ax?
Minus cos ax by a.
Yeah, minus cos ax by a. So just 1 plus n is nothing but constant value. That means it will become minus cos of 1 plus n into x by 1 plus n. Similarly, integration of this one is minus cos of 1 minus n into x by 1 minus n. Actually, we have to write bracket here, then it will be fine. So simply if you written like that, means it will not be fair. Okay, you have to write one bracket here because plus of minus is there. So now we have to apply the limit. So both are cosine function only. So that means it will not vanish in the interval 0 to pi. So in the first function, minus cos of 1 plus n by 1 plus n into x by 1 plus n. So minus 1 by 1 plus n, you can take it outside. Otherwise, since in both the terms, minus sign is common, you can take it out from the those two terms, you can take it out. That is minus I naught by 2 pi into. So here in the first term, 1 by 1 plus n is constant. 1 by 1 plus n is constant means, so just to apply the upper and lower limit, upper limit will become cos of 1 plus n into pi. Wherever x will be there, you have to replace by upper limit minus, wherever x will be there, you have to replace by 0. Cos of 1 plus n into 0 means it will become cos 0. So here actually it will be plus, but if we have written 1 by n minus 1 means it will be like taking negative sign outside. So that means it will become minus 1 by n minus 1 into upper limit is cos of 1 minus n into pi minus cos 0. So we know the value of cos n pi as well as cos 0. What is the value of cos n pi? Anybody?
Actually, it is
1
plus n, sir.
Yes, somebody is asking something. Who's that?
Sir, yes. N is equal to 1 plus n, sir.
Which one?
Cos of n plus 1 pi, no, sir.
Yeah, n plus 1 pi, 1 plus n pi, no problem. It will be fine only.
Yes, sir. Okay, then cos of 1 plus n pi is equal to minus 1 whole power 1 plus n, no, sir.
No, 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 not 1 plus n, n plus 1. It will be minus 1 power n only.
Oh, sir, can you explain it?
Which one? This one, now? Cos of 1 plus n into pi.
Yes, sir.
So, you are thinking it is 1 plus n. If you take an 1 plus n equals m means, it will become cos n pi. Cos n pi is what? Minus 1 power n, right? Cos n,
yes, sir,
minus 1 power n. So if you put n, m equals n plus 1 means it will become minus 1 power m, where m is 1 plus n. Yeah, we can, we have to write 1 plus n, Subramaniam. Right, you are right. Minus 1 power 1 plus n. So value anyway, it will, you will get same value, but the thing is what it will become. So 1 plus n if you put means even terms will become positive. Even terms become, you will get non-zero quantity for the even terms, and for the remaining terms you will get the zero. Okay. Is it fine, Subramaniam?
Yes, sir.
Minus 1 power n, which is equals to minus 1 power n plus 1 means we can write it as minus 1 into minus 1 power n. Even you take 1 plus n, you'll get the same answer at the end. After simplifying, you'll get same answer. In between, it will change us. Okay. So now I'll continue with minus 1 power n only because I'm already written. That's why if I'm going to change means here in between it will change. At the end we'll come out with the same answer only. Okay.
Sir, but how come we'll change 1 minus n, sir? It will change into denominators now.
This one. So just take negative sign outside. If you take negative sign outside means what we can write? Minus of n minus 1.
Not that, sir. Cos of 1 minus n pi.
Cos of?
1 minus n pi.
This one you are asking?
Yeah.
So cos of 1 minus n pi means what it will become? So minus 1 power 1 minus n only.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So then how, so in which manner you are thinking it will affect?
If we take minus outside common means 1 minus n, and it will come into denominator, also, n minus 1.
So 1 power anything is what?
1 only, sir.
1 only. If it is in denominator also, it will be same now. Only in a sign. Nothing will impact, right?
Yes, sir.
Even if it is 1 by minus 1 power n, in denominator is also there, means it will get, you will get the same thing only.
Yes, sir.
In case, in place of minus 1, in place of minus 1, if any other constant is there, means it will affect value. Okay.
Okay, sir. Yeah.
So now, from these two terms, we can take 1 minus minus 1 power n. So that means, first I will take negative sign outside. So negative sign, if you take outside, means this will become plus. That's why I took negative sign outside. After taking negative sign outside, one I naught by 2 pi into. So this will become 1 minus minus 1 power n into 1 plus, the remaining thing is 1 by 1 plus n minus 1 by n minus 1. So it will become n minus 1. So here it will become minus n minus 1. So now n will get cancelled. So 1 plus n into n minus 1 means n plus 1 into n minus 1 we can write. That is a square minus b square, n square minus 1. Okay. So now, so I'm not writing n square minus 1 as it is, because so in the term you see what we have to express 1 by 1 into 3 plus 1 by 3 into 5 plus 1 by 5 into 7. So that's why instead of writing n square minus 1, I'm writing it as 1 by n minus 1 into n plus 1. So if you put n equals to, it will become what? 1 into 3. If you put n equals 4 means it will become 3 into 5. So for that purpose, I'm not writing n square minus 1, just I'm writing n minus 1 into n plus 1. So just this thing you have to decide by seeing the, what you are going to prove. By seeing that expression, you have to decide. Okay. So now otherwise later it will be difficult to manage. That's why if you are making here itself, then it will be fine. Now, so this is not defined for a1. So if you put n equals 1 means this will become indeterminate. 1 by 0, that means indeterminate. So that's why this is not defined. This will be an will be defined for all the values except for n equals 1. So now we have to find out a1 separately. So by putting n equals 1 in the formula. So here an is, this is the formula. If you put n equals 1 means this will become 1 by pi into integral over 0 to 2 pi f of x cos x dx. Okay. So now use that formula. a1 equals 1 by pi into integral over 0 to 2 pi f of x cos x dx. So f of x 0 to 2 pi means first you have to split the integral into two parts, 0 to pi 1 and e pi to 2 pi. So in the interval 0 to pi, f of x is I naught sin x. And in the interval pi to 2 pi, f of x is 0. So now just to substitute these values, this second integral value will become 0, vanish. So now we have to integrate this one with respect to x. So here I naught is constant, we can take it out. And in place of sin x cos x, we can write? Sin x cos x. Anybody? In place of sin x cos x?
Sin
2x by 2. Sin 2x by 2. Yeah. So it will become, so because we know that sin 2x is nothing but 2 sin x cos x. If you want to make it in standard form, is just you have to multiply by 2 and divide by 2 for this sin x cos x. So in place of 2 sin x cos x, sin 2x divided by 2. So now I naught is constant, you take it out, I naught by, so this 2 is also constant, take it out, I naught by 2 pi into integration of sin 2x is minus cos 2x by 2, where the square is from 0 to pi. So it will become minus of minus cos 0. So cos 2 pi is 1, cos 0 is also 1. So that means this will become 0. A1 value is 0. So next we have to find out bn. Bn formula is 1 by pi equal over 0 to 2 pi f of x sin nx dx. So just to split this one. So after splitting, second integral value will become 0. First integral you have to integrate with respect to x. So sin x, sin nx means what we can write? Sin a sin b, what is the formula? Anybody? Sin a sin b. Anybody sin a sin b? Nobody remembered? Sin of sin a sin b, yes, ready?
Cos
of a minus b minus cos of a plus b, right?
Yes.
So use that formula. A value will become x and b value is nx. So it will become cos of x minus nx plus cos of x plus nx divided by 2. So just I naught by 2 is constant, you take it out, I naught by 2 pi into 0 to pi cos of 1 minus plus cos of 1 plus n into x. So integration of this one will become minus sine of 1 minus n into x divided by 1 minus n minus sine of 1 plus n into x divided by 1 plus n, where the limits varies from 0 to pi. What is this value of sine n pi?
0.
0. So but that means, and sine 0 also 0. So
zero.
The terms will become vanish. So this term also vanish and this term also vanish. Since the function is sine and the limits are 0 to pi, so the total bn value will become 0. So now we have to substitute these values in the function. What is that? F of x equals a naught plus an cos nx plus bn sin nx. So but an, we know the value, we got the an value for n not equals to 1. So this one is not defined for n equals 1. So for that purpose, just I will split the summation into two parts. So a1 cos x I will write, and remaining thing I will put it in summation form. N equals 2 to infinity an cos nx. And the other one is n equals 1 to infinity bn sin nx. So because, so if an, whatever we got the value that is not defined for a1, that's why I have written summation n equals to 1 to infinity an cos nx as a1 cos x plus n equals to 2 to infinity an cos nx. So now you substitute the value. A0 value is I0 by, what is the a0 value?
I0 by pi.
I0 by pi. Right. So 2, 2 will get cancelled. It will become I0 by pi plus a1 is 0. So that means it will become 0. This term will become 0. Plus an value equals 2 to infinity. An is I naught by pi into 1 minus minus 1 power n. So I'm cancelled 2 to actually. So it will become minus 1 by n minus 1 into n plus 1 into cos nx. And bn value is 0. So now you, by putting n equals 2 to infinity, just to expand this one, n equals 2 means it will become 1. So this one is I naught by pi, if you took outside, means this will become 1 plus, if you put n equals to minus 1 square, that means it will become vanish. Minus 1 square means it will become plus 1. So 1 minus of plus 1 means it will become minus, 1 minus 1, it will be 0. Right? No. So in 1 minute it will get disconnect. Just to join again. Okay, I'll continue.